little ruffled sweet pickles, I guess. And I didn't remove them this time. I ate them with the burger
Oh,
because the burger
wow.
was just so small. I felt like if I removed
It's like a
something,
3-bite burger.
yeah. And I was going to order another one, but I felt like they were watching me too. They were like, three of them came out to the front counter and were just kind of staring because I did have my little notepad out and I was writing things
Oh,
down.
but they don't know what you're noting.
I know, but they became a lot nicer to me afterwards. They were like, "Oh, thank you, sir." They took the tray from me. They did a lot of extra effort. They didn't do any of that for the old man who called them a slow burger.
Well, there you go.
Yeah, I wonder how many times they hear that though.
I'll say the service was excellent when I was there. Everyone was very kind, very
yeah.
nice. They were, I guess they're brand new, so they're a little uninformed. So it was often like something would be ordered. I'd be waiting around. They'd be like, "Oh, do you want this for my French fries?" After maybe 2 minutes after I ordered the place, I was just sort of wandering around. They said, "Oh, would you like sweet French fries?" I was like, "Okay, sure." And then for my broily, they said, "Do you want a spicy sauce?" And I said, "Sure."
These are all code things. It's
right?
Like if you answered the right way.
And there were sweet potato fries
yeah.
and a little spicy sauce. But yes, finish your thought on your burger.
It wasn't fantastic, but it wasn't terrible. It was just a regular burger. It was a fine burger. There was nothing else to it. I was just more blown away by how this place was open. The burger itself, I think, was pretty good. It was fine, but I can't imagine. I'm going to say it right now that I don't think they will be open 6 months from now.
Now, presuming that they were able to keep paying their rent without any income whatsoever for 5 years would, to me, mean that they will stay in business for quite some time, and
yeah.
it will be inexplicable. The only explanation I can make on how this is an okay business play is that they will be open late night on weekends.
Okay.
So the people trickling out of the bars can go, "Oh, I could go to Quick Burger."
Yeah, maybe they can capture that market, just like get all the people coming out of the bars. But your place is, you don't want that to be your place. Like, that's what McDonald's on Guy is now.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a dirty place.
Now, what's interesting to me is that they are on the same block as a Burger King, which opened long after their opening soon at Quick Burger banner went up.
Yeah.
Like, it was a grocery store, and then that grocery store closed and became a couple different businesses, all the while Quick Burger was opening soon.
Building anticipation.
Well, that's it. And it's just so incredibly ironic that Quick Burger took 5 years to open.
That was the big joke. Did you happen to ask anybody there what the deal was?
I did not, because it also seemed like anyone there would not have the answer.
No. I was thinking about it. I almost asked, but when I had such a hard time getting the answer of what the difference between the broily and the burgie was, I figured I wouldn't ask.
Exactly. I felt like I wasn't going to get an answer.
Yeah.
But they have a Burger King on their block and a McDonald's a block away. Their burgie and cheesy and double cheesy are mimics of burgers at McDonald's that are better at McDonald's. And their broily is a mimic of a Whopper that's much better at Burger King. So,
are the prices better?
No, the prices are comparable.
Okay.
Right now, I think Burger King, you can get two Whoppers for $6 before tax. And the broily is like $6.50.
Okay. And their washrooms won't cut and crush you.
Yes. So. I had a double cheesy at first.
Okay.
I got to my, I waited around, like 7 minutes, 6-7 minutes. I got my burger, sat down, unraveled it, and saw it appeared to have one patty.
Mm.
So I was like, "Oh, I waited this long and I didn't even get the burger I was supposed to." So I went back and said, "Hey," I lifted the bun and said, "Look, there's only one piece of meat." And they're like, "Oh, okay, okay." Brought it back to the kitchen. And then I was like, eating my French fries, and they brought back the burger wrapped up again. I was like, "Oh, thank you." And she said, "There were actually two patties. The other one was just hiding under the cheese." And I couldn't see it because it was such a little patty, like buried in the bread under the cheese.
It was
like,
very timid.
"Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realize." She said, "But we added an extra patty anyway."
Yeah.
And I was like, "Oh, that's so nice. Thank you." And I took a bite of it, and each patty was so bad. It was like they were just dry and burnt and no good. Really, it was just like bread and ash and pickles.
Bread and ash and pickles.
It was not a good burger, but I ate it and was like, okay, well, let me give them another shot.
Okay.
Let me try this broily, because maybe that's the thing.
Yeah.
Because they even had like TV screens with different menu items, and the burgy was not on them, but the broily was. So I said, okay, let me just try a broily. The sweet potato fries were fine. I got no problems with the sweet potato fries. Could have been a bigger portion, but that's fine. It's fine. It was fine.
Yeah.
I ordered a broily, got a broily. It was assembled like a mess. You wouldn't have liked the tomatoes because they were very thick. Ugh. But I was okay with that. But it was assembled like a mess. Not very much sauce on it. And again, the patty. So dry, so burnt, so bad. Not a good burger. Mm. Sesame seed bun.
Yeah.
That's nice.
Did it look voluptuous at all?
It looked like a worse Whopper.
Okay. Because the images that they took, I noticed they took the
that image on that TV screen looked like they took a picture of a Whopper.
Yeah. Or they took the larger burgers at
a low angle. Stock photo of a Whopper.
Yeah, it did look. It was a low angle. All of the smaller burgers were taken from like an upper angle, like, so they looked smaller, but they didn't look as small as the one I got.
Mm-hmm. Very tiny little burger.
Very tiny. I did feel like eating more, but I had no time.
Okay.
Maybe if they were as quick as you'd imagine, I would have had time, but I did not.
Matthew, are you ready to rate this burger? Do you have any other final comments on Quick Burger before you rate the burger?
This place had like a little waiting area when you walked in, like a leather long sofa, with this weird closed off section that looked like a receptionist would be standing there.
Yeah, it looks like in the summer they might serve ice cream from there.
That would be delightful. That would be
a second cache for some reason.
That would be, out of all the reasons to walk away, that would be one good one to stay.
Yeah. Yeah. But no, this place is confusing. You go in and you are immediately greeted by like a desk counter area that it's empty. It's blank. Yeah. It's new. It's clean, but it's got no purpose.
No.
And so you walk to the back of the restaurant and order there and sit at like these strange little tables. Yeah. I don't know, man.
And you immediately feel pressure when you walk in. As soon as you walk in, it's like maybe not everybody feels that pressure, but I sure do because... You know, the cashier just looks right at you and mm-hmm. waiting, and I'm looking at the menu from as far away as I can, and I'm still feeling that pressure.
Walked up, right up, and just stared up at the menu, and I was like, okay, let me try this.
Yeah.
The prices are reasonable, though.
They are reasonable, and with the large Pepsi, that's another point.
That's another positive
in their favor.
Yeah.
I'm going to rate this burger I think I'm going to give it a 5.5. I'm going to give it a, 5.5.
I've got a feeling that you had a better burger experience today than I did yesterday.
Well, it's just like, you know, if I paid $20 and I got this burger, no way they're going to get a 3. This is just a fine little, like, walk-in in the summer burger. If they can increase the speed, maybe mm-hmm. even open up a little window on the side where you could just order a burger without having to walk inside.
Mm. You just don't want to go in that restaurant.
But they want people to see the fountain.
Yeah. I can't be so generous. I had a burger, did not care for it, tried another burger. It was a little better because it had ingredients on it that were fresher and juicier, so it kind of masked the dry ashiness of the burger. Mm. I have to give this burger like a 2.
Really, a 2?
Yeah, it's a garbage burger.
I had no problem. Like, to me, it was a fine little burger just to eat on the go, not like sit down at a restaurant and eat a burger. Mm-hmm. But you know, with all the anticipation, it definitely does not.
Doesn't help
the hype
but no, it's a garbage burger. Honestly, both of the burgers I had, I feel like would have been better if you just removed the patties. That's how bad they were.
This is a pretty wide.
They tasted like gray looks.
Yeah, maybe I just had like because I had so little, I didn't even have cheese on mine. I think I just had two very very thin patties, and there was more ketchup and mustard than patties. So maybe that's what I tasted.
Okay, maybe you're just a fan of ketchup and mustard.
Maybe. I don't know. I got to revisit this, I think. And I'm still going to give it the 5.5, but I feel like if you're giving it a 2 and I'm giving it 3.5 points higher, I think we need to maybe revisit this again.
Well, let me know, Matthew, and we'll reconvene next episode to see if your opinion has changed. Okay. But I can't give this higher than a 2. If the $1.50 burger at McDonald's is better than the $1.50 burger at Quick Burger that they're ripping off, What are we doing here?
Nah.
It's so much worse. It's so much worse. And I'm not a big fan of McDonald's.
No.
But it's so much worse. And if I could get a $6.50 knockoff Whopper that's so much worse than a Whopper that I could get two of for $6, what are we doing?
I don't know.
The staff was very nice. Mm. So pleasant. Very. They brought me my second burger while I was munching on my fries. I was surprised and very grateful.
Yeah.
Very, very nice. But, oh, my God, this business is confusing.
Yeah, I mean, you had 5+ years to perfect a burger. I'm saying that assuming that you put a bit of thought into it before you decided to open up a burger restaurant, that maybe you had an idea of a recipe. But this doesn't really seem like they thought about it at all.
No. This looks like they had two different styles of patties presented to them by some distributor.
Yeah.
And they were like, oh, okay, we could do this. It feels like they probably, I don't know how they burn them and cook them so bad. Like, they're so dry. I don't understand how you can make them so dry and it take that long.
Hmm. Well, maybe we had different cooks that day.
We may have. So let's. So I went in an evening, afternoon, and you went in a morning.
Yeah.
So who knows? But there were 4 or 5 guys scrambling back there to make one burger and fries. And they did a terrible job. Too many cooks in the kitchen, perhaps.
That could be. That could be. Well, we'll try it again one day. Maybe we'll do a quick burger redux. If only because I want to see this place one last time before it's gone. And we should place a bet that this place will not be around in 6 months.
Okay. I will.
You think it's going to be around
forever. I'll bet you a burger.
Yeah.
Like a decent burger, not a quick burger.
Okay.
That in 6 months' time, so let's say January, February, March, April, May, June.
Yeah.
By the beginning of July.
Sure. July 1st.
If by July 1st they are still open, you owe me a burger.
Okay.
If they do not make it to July 1st, I owe you a burger.
Okay. And just to clarify, if their sign is in the window, but the lights are off and I can't get in during regular business hours.
That's right.
And they're just not really open, but they still own the building. I'm not counting that as them
okay,
being open.
Okay, I've got a little follow-up question, though. A little caveat. What if there's a new banner that says reopening soon?
No.
Okay.
No, then I still win.
Okay. okay, hold on. What if there's, like, a fire?
That still counts because it feels like it would be a fire brought on by them for insurance purposes.
Okay, Matthew. So I'm giving this burger a 2. You're giving it a 5.5.
Yeah.
I feel like we both need to go back. You try in the evening and I'll try in the day. Maybe we'll get opposite cooks.
Well, let's go at the same time maybe and really, really talk to each other while we eat this burger. To
really communicate about this burger.
Yeah.
It's such a great dry burger.
Maybe we can even it out around 3.5.
Maybe. We'll see. So, Matthew, you're done school this week.
Yeah.
You're going to have a little more time on your hands.
I will. I don't know what I'll do today. You know, I didn't have school for one day, and I slept until way too long.
Well, that's marvelous.
So I really hope that that's not what happens for the rest of my life.
Well, it wouldn't be that bad. Matthew, in the new year, we're not having an episode next week.
No.
For the new year, we may just go back to weekly episodes of Cadeau and Janko, When's His Lunch?
We may.
I feel like over these past couple months, listeners are needing more. I'm missing podcasting with you so much, Matthew. I'm missing something in my life.
Yeah.
And it's this show.
Okay.
We need to bring it back. We need to double down.
Double down?
We're going to... Well, no. Well...
Just
re-up.
Okay.
we need to go on this road trip that I've been saying.
Oh, God. I don't know if you've talked about it publicly, but this road trip just doesn't seem feasible.
I think you need to save like $1,000.
It keeps going up. It keeps going up.
But next week we're skipping. In the new year, Matthew, we're probably, you've got a little more time on your hands. We'll have a little more time to go out and get lunch together. But when we do go out for lunch, what do you think we'll end up getting?
I think new year, new lease on life.
Interesting.
We got some New Year's resolutions that I think we can work on.